Internet. Welcome to another episode of the Bunkai Breakdown, the show where we take techniques from traditional martial arts and show you if, when, and how they can be used in real life. I'm your host, Mr. T, and in this episode, we'll be looking at the down block, or the Hadanaki. The Encyclopedia of Taekwondo calls this a low block, either a low forearm block for closed-handed techniques in the case of Saju Chirigi or Chunji, or a low knife hand block in the case of Sajumaki. In traditional karate, it's called a Geran Uke, which incidentally is also a command you'll hear thrown around a judo dojo quite a bit. And if you understood that joke, then you need to get a life because you are as big of a martial arts nerd as I am. That being said, let's take a look at this and see how it's done.
Let's see this move from a front stance. According to General Che's Encyclopedia of Taekwondo, a proper down block will come from an X position. This X should be about chin level to make maximum use of gravity. We always want to fight gravity as little as possible. The hand that's closest to you will execute the block. The fingers of the blocking hand face you, while the opposite hand faces away from you. This is because the final position of the block calls for both hands to rotate, so that the blocking hand faces away from you, and the other hand faces towards you. This corkscrew motion of the wrists and forearms will show up in almost every hand technique of Taekwondo, and I'll explain why in a moment. The hand that isn't blocking is called the reaction hand, and is brought to this position above the belt. Avoid curling your wrist. In fact, Taekwondo almost always calls for straight wrists in nearly every technique. The purpose of the X position, the wrist rotation, and the reaction hand is to make maximum use of a principle called reaction force. This is one of the five theories of power. Reaction force is a principle in physics that delivers maximum energy to the opponent while distributing the energy of the motion evenly through your own body. In karate and WTF Taekwondo, you'll see the moves chambered in this universal block, which protects your face and body prior to the execution of the block. This position provides wonderful coverage, and this is actually my go-to fighting stance when I'm doing sport Taekwondo. From that perspective, the universal block may actually provide better protection than the X position. But the X makes better use of reaction force to provide power to the technique and distribute the energy through your shoulders to reduce the risk of injury. The final position of the block calls for the elbow to be bent slightly to cover the ribs, abdomen, and marginally the groin. This will also prevent hyperextension of the elbow. This bend occurs at the elbow, not the wrist. The bend will be slightly less pronounced in an open hand down block. Avoid resting your arm on the knee or against the body. This is a lazy habit and renders the block ineffective. Keep the block within your shoulder width, or your vital areas will be exposed, and the block will likely miss entirely. The down block was designed to defend against a front snap kick to the solar plexus, a front snap kick to the kidneys, a roundhouse kick to the kidneys or ribs, or a hook kick to the kidneys or ribs. This block can be effective, particularly if the kicker catches the elbow with their foot. That hurts. But there's a huge danger in that you leave your face extremely exposed to knockout kicks and knockout punches. According to Professor Paul Tom, who's a jiu-jitsu black belt under Grandmaster Flavio Baring, it was karate guys doing low blocks that led to the invention of the Superman punch in MMA, as seen here. Let's see that again. Notice how he sets these up with the low kicks. There was one, here comes another one, and then he's going to fake the kick, and then Superman punch. Now, he's actually got an advantage here. He's going to push off the cage. Usually, you can just throw your body horizontal, but he's going to be able to push off with that back leg. And you notice this guy gets his hands up, but it's too slow. He takes one right on the chin, and he is down. Here's another example from a karate fight. Same problem. Let's look at that again. So he fakes the low kick, that hand comes down, and catches the punch right on the chin. Let's look at one more. To avoid exposing yourself in such a critical way in a real fight, be it a combat sport or a self-defense situation, I recommend avoiding this block altogether. Shane Fazin has an awesome video on how to defend against a roundhouse kick without getting KO'd, and you should definitely go check it out. I'll link to it in the video and in the description.
So, in my opinion, the down block works, but its drawbacks make it too dangerous for real use in combat sports or in self-defense. Do you agree with my analysis? Tell us in the comments below. We're always open to suggestions, so tell us which move you'd like to see next. Remember to like and subscribe. This has been Mr. T with the Bunkai Breakdown, reminding you that perfection is our goal, but excellence will be tolerated.